So it is official. The Florida Senate race is now facing another recount, this time by hand. New numbers released by Florida Secretary of State show Republican Rick Scott leading Democratic Senator Bill Nelson by 12,603 votes, or 0.15%. That is within legal margin for a hand recount. But three counties in the state failed to meet today's deadline for machine recounts, and I'm talking about Broward, Hillsborough, and Palm Beach counties. That means their initial tallies, their totals from last week, those totals will stand. Broward County was actually just 2 minutes late with the new recount totals, but the Secretary of State wouldn't accept the results. Just 2 minutes late. What excuse is there for Broward County cutting it so close? Palm Beach County is blaming their 11-year-old voting machines. They apparently overheated, causing mismatched results and forcing staffers to redo their work. Susan Bucker, the supervisor of elections in the county, said that those faulty machines made meeting today's deadline impossible.
We gave it everything we had. I'm very proud of my team, and we are a good election office, and I have a great team. I think that we just got stuck with some mechanical issues that were inherited.
Mechanical issues? It's 2018, and you're blaming mechanical issues? Really? That's embarrassing. It's even more embarrassing because this is not the first time that they've dealt with voting machine problems. Remember this? 18 years ago, Palm Beach County was home to the controversial butterfly ballot at the heart of the 2000 recount. Many voters said that they may have voted for the wrong candidate because they were confused. Palm Beach was also one of the counties where recounts were conducted using punch card ballots. Remember officials looking at partially punched ballots where they were dimple chads or hanging chads? Remember that? Why are there still issues? And Palm Beach County is not alone. Hillsborough County is blaming two power outages and lost a voting machine for a drop in votes counted. That's why they decided to stick with the initial numbers. This is unacceptable. Get some new machines, ones that work, figure it out. Crucial Florida counties not meeting this deadline disenfranchises voters. It means that their votes were not counted. Now that is not American, that's un-American. There are a lot of people in this country who make baseless claims about voter fraud in the United States. This kind of incompetence, frankly, doesn't help that. The 2020 election, less than 2 years away, and Florida is a key state. Every vote must count in Florida, every state in this nation. The integrity of the country's election system is at stake.